Hello and welcome to Gearheads. My name's Jesse and today I want to go over a small list of things from Harbor Freight that I personally found very helpful when I was first starting out in this business. So I hope this video helps anybody out there who's looking to get started, working as a mechanic or technician, or also anybody that's working at home. I know there's a lot of you guys out there that, you know, work on stuff at the house, or you want to start learning to work on cars, and the truth is you need tools to do that. So with this video, I'm going to assume that you already have mechanics, a basic mechanics tool set. There's a lot of them out there. Maybe I'll do a video on one soon, so let me know down in the comments if that's something you guys would be interested to see. But like I said, I'm going to assume that you guys already have a basic socket set, socket wrenches, basic normal wrench set, some pliers and stuff like that. And these are just a few things to add on to that kit to make make your collection a little bit more useful. So obviously when you're first starting out, things can get very expensive very fast. If you walk onto a tool truck as a mechanic, or if you're a DIY guy just walking into Home Depot or even Harbor Freight or somewhere else, there's going to be so many things on the shelf that you see that you're going to want, but you have to be careful and not buy more than you really need. The best and the smartest thing to do is start with a smaller toolbox or tool cart, buy simple stuff and exactly what you know you're going to need, and then add on and slowly grow from there. You don't start off with a giant toolbox full of tools that cost a lot of money. You slowly build yourself there over time. So, and that's one of the beautiful things about Harbor Freight. They have a lot of things there that are very affordable, and you can buy a lot of them, not in giant kits. You can buy a lot of things individually there too. So you can just buy exactly what you need and roll with that until you're ready to move on to something else. So let's go ahead and get started with the first thing I have on the list. Number one, the half inch drive lug nut socket set. So this covers metric and SAE for almost all of the common lug sizes that you're gonna find on a lot of different vehicles. Now, if you're starting off in a shop somewhere, you're probably gonna be doing a lot of oil changes. You might be doing brake jobs. You're gonna be doing tire rotations and stuff like that. And you're gonna be pulling wheels off and installing them pretty often. And one thing you're gonna wanna make sure of when you're doing that is you're not damaging your customer's wheels. These sockets are really good about protecting wheels. They have a nice nylon sleeve that goes over the outside. So if you go to pop a wheel loose, you're taking that last lug off and the wheel kind of tilts down because you weren't holding it carefully enough, which you should be, but things happen. Sometimes it moves around, whatever. The point is, with the nylon sleeve around the socket, it's going to protect the wheels and keep them from getting damaged. Now this set runs about $40. That's a little bit more than some of Harbor Freight's other impact socket sets that they have, but this is more, like I said, for a specific use. Use them specifically for wheels. Their other impact socket sets are also great buys, but I already covered that in one of the other videos I did, that other top 10 video. So after this one's over, if you want to see some more recommendations from Harbor Freight, feel free to go check that one out. All right, second thing on the list is going to be the Pittsburgh Pro Breaker Bar, or also they now are selling the Icon Breaker Bars. So the weird thing about these is I was standing in the store looking at them back to back, and the Pittsburgh Pro one pretty much looks exactly like the new Icon one. The handles are basically identical, and the metal is basically identical. The only difference I could tell, the Icon one was basically a half an inch longer, but it was over twice the price. The Pittsburgh Pro ones are still going for $20. So if you're looking at buying something like this soon, I'd buy it now, because I'm kind of suspecting they're just gonna start selling off all the Pittsburgh Pro stuff and only be carrying the Icon stuff now. And the thing is, the Icon one's $50, which is over double the cost. I don't understand why they're hiking the price up so much, but hey, buy the Pittsburgh Pro ones while you can. Those ones are really strong. They've worked good for me. I have one in my Jeep that I use for side work a lot, and we have one at my buddy's house, and we've had that one there for like 3 or 4 years, and that thing's been really good for us there as well. So check those out. And the next item on the list is going to be a torque wrench. So obviously if you're gonna be doing engine rebuilds and some critical things on the vehicle, you probably don't wanna be trusting a Harbor Freight torque wrench. But I have seen online, I've had a few of these and they've worked well for me so far, and I haven't broken them, but I have seen a lot of good reviews online by people that actually hook them up and measure them and recalibrate them, and they've all been pretty good actually, and I'm very impressed with how accurate they are considering the price, because you can pick these things up for $10 to $20 depending on depending on the size you're looking for. The 3/8 and the half inch, I believe, are $20. I think the quarter inch one is either 10 or 15. They're basically on clearance all the time now, and part of the reason they're on clearance is, once again, they're starting to upgrade to the new Icon line. So I don't know if they're going to be keeping these old Pittsburgh ones around or if they're going to be phasing them out and getting rid of them, but they are useful. And you know, when you're working on stuff, when you're learning, it's very important to make sure you get the feel of things. And without a torque wrench, if you have no other frame of reference, you're not going to know how tight you're actually installing stuff. When you're starting out, that's important. You don't want to be breaking things from installing them too tight. Next up on the list is their two-piece sets of long reach angle pliers. So they have two different sets of these. They have both sets come with a straight one, and one set comes with a 45 degree and the other set comes with a 90 degree. Personally, I would get the set that comes with the straight and the 45 degree ones. I find these to be a lot more useful than a straight, you know, 90 degree bend. Those are not quite as good for reaching into weird spots. There's a lot of times that having that 45 degree angle helps you get to something. These are very useful for hose clamp pliers as well as many other things, and I have found them invaluable and still use them almost every single day. And I've had them for about 6 years now and they haven't broken yet. That set is about $7.99, I believe, unless you get it with a coupon. And I also felt it was worth mentioning these big, really long guys. The truth is, I don't use these ones very often, and they're not that good for things that are really, really tight because they flex so much. So if you've got something you have to get a really tight grip on that's far away, it might not be very easy. But they're really good for picking up things that might have fallen into a hard to reach spot. And every once in a while, there is something that I have found I just can't get with any of my other tools. And I do have the 90 degree ones for these. Every once in a while, those work good for maybe a squeeze clamp that's real deep down, and this allows you to get to it. Another similar tool to the one I just mentioned, coming in at around $15, is their hose clamp plier sets. These things are awesome. I remember before I had found out about these when I was first starting out, I was trying to use, you know, you start out using your hands, and if the hose doesn't want to come off, then maybe you take a pair of pliers, try and twist and break the hose loose. If that doesn't get it off, or if you can't get the pliers on there, then you're going to end up having to cut it. Now, there's still going to be a lot of times that a hose is going to be really stubborn, or it might be old and the rubber is brittle and hardened, and you're just going to have to cut it and there's no other way. But I can tell you that these will help you avoid that a lot of the time, and they're also useful for some other things as well. Sometimes like quick release clips, I found these things work really good. That depending on what manufacturer it is, they all have different ways of doing their squeeze and release pins for fuel lines, heater core lines, stuff like that. And sometimes I've been able to use these guys to get around the hose and pinch the pins or the buttons, however they have them set up, on both sides, and then pull with your hand to release the hose. Any case, very useful set of tools for $15. Last thing on the list, I don't actually have with me here today, but me and my buddy have it up at his house where we work on stuff, and we've been using that thing there for about 3 years now, 4 years maybe, and that thing works really well. It's the Earthquake half inch drive impact. So I also do have some experience with some of the other Harbor Freight air tools, and most of them have been pretty good. One of the guys here at work had one of those old grinders. He bought that thing back in the day for like less than $10, I think, and it lasted him for over 10 years until it finally broke a few months ago. So I'd say that was definitely worth the price of admission. But in any case, most of the new Earthquake guns that are coming out now are all really powerful, and they have a good warranty. So even if for some reason it does break on you or doesn't last, if you do have a Harbor Freight close by, you can always go and swap it out for another one. And for somebody just starting out, it's a really affordable and good way to get into using air tools, because that Earthquake one that we have in my buddy's house, it is not as strong as my Matco half inch gun that I use here at work, but it is almost as strong, and it is about... it's almost about a tenth of the price. So I think it's a really good way to go for somebody starting out and just getting into this. So that's about it for my list. Obviously, you know, it wasn't too long. It wasn't gonna be a super long video, but I did wanna show you guys, you know, just some of the stuff that I've found helpful and I think useful things for people getting started. You don't always know all of the stuff that's out there. So I hope you found this helpful. If you have any questions or you have any comments and you have any other recommendations you'd like to share with me or anybody else, then drop them down in the comments. I always like to hear other people's recommendations too. Sometimes I hear about stuff that I didn't even know existed, and that's always really cool. So anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, hit the thumbs up button and leave a like. If you want to see more videos like this, subscribe. And as always, keep wrenching. If you want to watch more videos like this, hit the subscribe button and God damn it.
If you didn't like it, f*** off.
Yeah, if you didn't like it, f*** you!